and I'm in Golfton area of Connorskey, and I'm sitting with someone that I haven't seen for many years. Tell me, with whom am I chatting this afternoon?
Peter Wilcock.
Now then, Peter, we've known each other in a time of Deeside when it was in its heyday. Tell me what you did in those days.
I was projectionist at the Alhambra, Shotton, Hippodrome, Connorskey, Plaza Queen's Ferry.
Now, three cinemas, that's a lot of responsibility. Tell me what your work entailed, Peter.
Making the programme up on a Monday morning, that's splicing film together. If it was 10 reels, you joined them up into doubles, which gave you part 1 and 2, 3 and 4 together, 5 and 6, 7 and 8, up to 10, whatever the film, the length of it. And then we change over from one projector to the other every 20 minutes, which takes quite a bit of explaining. There'd be a queue on the screen in the right-hand corner, left, no, the right-hand corner, top right-hand corner. A black dot would appear. Now, the projectionist, seeing that dot, would start the motor going on the oncoming projector. A few seconds later, another dot would come, and he would shut the existing projector off, and exactly the same time, the other one would come on. I mean, just a change of scene, that's all.
This was quite complicated work. Was it classed and respected as a skilled occupation, Peter?
Well, you wouldn't think so, but yes, it'd be hopeless putting somebody you'd never get a picture on the screen if you hadn't had the, you know, what to do, like, you know.
On the basis you were putting on a show, did you feel you were really part of the entertainment industry?
Oh, definitely, yes, definitely. I did anyway, yeah.
What was the competition in its day?
To
the cinema.
To the cinema, well, there wasn't a lot except for billiards and things like that.
People often ask me about those days, how did I come to get my first interest in cine,
yeah,
and movies? And I think we shared a common interest at that time. What was it?
Deeside Cine Club, yeah. It was nice, that.
Tell me what that was about. What sort of things went on there?
Well, a group of us go out together, and if we could think of a little film, a story, we'd try our best to make the film of it all. The first one Steve and I made was called All's Well. And taking the mickey out of the old silent serials, actually, although we had sound on it as a background, it was taking the mickey out of the old silent serials. Then I made one with taking the mickey out of James Bond, 007 and a half, or 6 and a half, I figure. And yeah, we enjoyed making that. That won 3 stars in the Amateur Cine magazine, you remember that?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, won 3 stars in that. Yeah.
It surprises me, and I'm sure it does you, that now everyone's got a video camera in their mobile phone. How few people can use them with any creativity.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Now, if we had those days, it'd be marvellous.
We'd have changed the world, wouldn't we?
Yeah, I mean, it's great just having the musical background, you know.
But just think how we struggled to get the lip sync, to get the sound precisely synchronised.
Oh, I never tried that. I knew I couldn't do that well. But I suppose there was many that you must have tried it then.
Got it right sometimes.
Did you?
Yes. Yeah.
Dear me.
Yeah, but it always went wrong on the night. Right, well, I think we've had a nice little chat today.
I hope so.
So I'm going to say thank you very much, Peter, for a most enjoyable afternoon.
Very good.
And you're going to show me now into the cinema. We're going to have a look at your cinema and see what you've done to recreate something of the nostalgia. And you've got lots of memorabilia and various artifacts all to do with that era. But for all that you're doing and the way you're preserving these memories, thank you very much, Peter.
Okay,
thank you.
John.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Right.
Brilliant, that. And I think we've got it just before the weather changes.